Yeah, Brooks likes that, close that distance with those punches, gets inside the clinch. This first little exchange right here is going to tell us a lot. You know, I'd expect Brooks to try to put Bokang down, but Bokang is very explosive, very agile. The way that he was stopping takedowns from Sawada was really impressive. There's a nice little hip toss. Bokang does a beautiful job of staying on his feet as Brooks jumps to the back.
Oh, have a look at that from Jared Brooks riding Bokang Masunyane. Nicely done from the American.
Let's see what Brooks can do here with this back position. He's a little bit off to the side. The first thing Bokang has to do is protect his neck, make sure that rear naked choke is not inside. And he might try to use the wall to press him up against and then try to push his back against the wall so that he can try to scoot around. You can see Brooks triangle the legs, give him a little bit better grip. Now he's sinking in that rear naked choke. Here it comes.
Masunyane defending against the human backpack that is Jared Brooks here in the first round.
Brooks trains with a lot of high-level jiu-jitsu practitioners out there in Detroit, Michigan. He's been working a lot on his submission game.
Softening up Masunyane a little more. That figure four, that triangle wrapped around the body of the South African.
That's what Masunyane's got to do. He's got to try to get his right leg behind the right leg of Jared Brooks so that he can relieve some of that pressure and work his way out of this triangle. Brooks has got good back control.
You hear Jared Brooks grunting behind every one of these strikes. Looping the knuckles around to hit the top of the head of Masunyane. Masunyane making the phone call to defend against that left hand of Brooks.
Brooks is able to slice that hand in, get right there underneath the chin. He threatens to go to the other side as Bokang defends the left arm. Beautiful job there from Bokang.
Big hello to the champion, Joshua Pasha, in Bagyar City in the Philippines right now watching this one. Whoever wins will take on the champ, Pasha. Body shot then head from Jared Brooks, trying to open up that neck of Masunyane, sink the strangle from behind.
We're good there.
What are the options here for Masunyane, Dragon?
Well, he's trying to do it. He's trying to take his right leg and put it behind Brooks's right leg, but Brooks is doing a good job of keeping his foot hidden behind the leg, so he's not able to relieve pressure from the back mount. And you can see how Brooks is trying to attempt to threaten with the rear naked choke, and Bokang's doing a good job of peeling off whatever hand is threatening the neck. So he's doing a good job of defending. He's choosing to stay upright, which is a smart move on his part, so that Brooks really can't advance his position or do much as far as ground and pound, flattening him out. But it's going to wear on the legs of Bokang a little bit to carry all that weight of Jared Brooks.
Mitch, a lot of people who aren't used to seeing this position may be asking, why can't Masunyane just fall back really hard and try and slam Brooks onto his back?
He could, but in doing so, it's going to open up a possible transition into the rear naked choke. So as he throws his head back, it's going to open him up. And it's not going to do that much. You know, the pressure of that, you know, jump essentially is just going to put Brooks into a better position. It's better for Bokang to just sit here, defend the rear naked choke, and he might choose to ride out the rest of this round in this position because his rear naked choke defense is pretty solid. But it's a very dominant position for Brooks.
110 remaining. Brooks tries to soften him up a little more. Look for an opening where he can loop around that neck of Bokang Masunyane. Patience, though, from Jared Brooks. So, too, from Masunyane. Number one and number two ranked in the strawweight division. Cranking here.
Yeah, it's just basically a face crank. It's really uncomfortable, but you can see Bokang's got good submission defense. See, this is where Brooks might want to go palm to palm, right? If he can get that arm underneath the neck, you can see that he's a little bit close. He's close to it. Bokang might go out. This might be it. He's got 30 seconds.
Is this it?
That's good.
That's it.
That's Jared Brooks. It's going to be Jared Brooks and Joshua Pasha.
I am. Woo!
That was good work. He was patient. He was calm.
Who's coming, Joshua Pasha? Me. That's me, baby. You better get that shit right.
He was beautifully set up. He knew exactly what he wanted.
What
and once he got that arm
shot
under the neck,
three.
He went palm to palm.
Where you at, baby?
And not enabling Bokang to defend.
So
look. right there, right underneath the chin. You can see Bokane falls to the ground, and then the choke gets deeper, and out he goes.
Jared Brooks books his spot against Joshua Pasha, and tremendous respect. Honor between athletes. Let's go to Tom Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Mohammed Sulaiman, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 39 seconds in the very first round for your winner by way of rear naked choke, Jared